Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Let me at the outset thank Dr. Sai Kumar for organizing this wonderful course. I'm going to talk to you on my interesting multifocal case diaries in the next few minutes. How many of you are using multifocals regularly in this audience? Okay, I don't see many hands going up, but let us clear the facts. Sun is setting on the old mindset of cataract surgery. The old mindset is a patient who is really old and coming with a dense nucleus, and you just have to give some vision to these patients and the patients will fall at your feet. Okay, but new mindset is these patients are very highly demanding patients. The patients are very highly demanding. They want good vision for distance, intermediate, near vision as well. And it's a changing profile of the cataract patients. They're younger and active in life. They are more economically independent, ready to spend on themselves, educated, hugely aware of the options and the possibilities, and also highly demand lifestyle changes as well. This is the old technology of 1GB in 1991, which is as big as the size of this room, and 1GB now we can just put it in your wallet. And again, missions have also changed, newer technology, newer missions. Sai Kumar was enumerating all these things. Now, I'm going to give you four mantras as far as the refractive cataract surgery is concerned. Now, increase the refractive, number one, increase the refractive accuracy. Now, we are talking about the various IOL formulas and which IOL formula will be suitable for which axial length, which condition, and all these things. Key number two, decrease the complications. By complications, what I mean is, deliver clear corneas in all these patients consistently. You have good viscoelastics, good phaco modulation, cold phaco, all these are available to deliver consistently clear corneas in all these patients. Because clear cornea is an important aspect to deliver, irrespective of the density of the cataract, to deliver good vision for these patients and good good distant vision, near vision, intermediate vision as well. Avoid complications like Rexel's tear or posterior capsule rupture and all these patients and all, all cystoid macular edema. I would prefer you to use NSAIDs for all these patients with multifocal lenses. Look at the ocular surface. I think the previous speakers are also talked about this. The ocular surface is very important. Many of us don't even look at the ocular surface. Straight away you take the slit lamp onto the lens. Am I right or not? You don't even look at the cornea. You don't even look at the ocular surface. And so this is a preoperative evaluation. Looking at the ocular surface is necessary because once you take care of the ocular surface, it's very important because especially in a multifocal lens. Choose the IOL that gives the best visual quality. N6 is not the goal. Please understand. The goal is happy patients. How do you get these happy patients? The happy patients are got by giving them good quality of vision. Good quality of vision. Exceed the patient expectations. That is key four. Set realistic expectations. That is, you can't make this old lady like Aishwarya Rai, definitely after a blepharoplasty surgery, but you can make her better than this. This is called realistic expectations. You need to tell the patients, multifocal lenses, that you can read N6 or N8, small letters, but you can't read in poor light, in a candlelight, when they go to a restaurant. That's important. So again, we have to tell them what is realistic, what is expected, what is the outcome of this particular surgery when they undergo the multifocal lenses. Refractive surgery, you will see better, but not like when you are 21 years old, under promise and over deliver. These are the four mantras I want you to remember as far as multifocal practice is concerned. Increasing refractive accuracy, decreasing the complications, choose the best quality visual quality IOLs, exceed the patient expectations. Now let's go to the multifocal lenses. Good for far vision, intermediate vision nowadays, new trifocal lenses, good for near vision also. Demerits. The demerits are the halos, glare, night vision difficulty, decreased contrast. That's the reason why all of us are fearing to use multifocal. Am I right or not? This is because there's a lot of demerits coming with the thing. Of course, the demerits are much less with the newer generation multifocal lenses. But still it is there. Now, let's see these multifocal lenses. Refractive and diffractive. These are the two components. The refractive was the older type. Case one, this patient multifocal lenses, the array lens was operated in 2002. And after about a couple of years, the patient had a dislocation, or I'm sorry, decentered or subluxated IOL in this case, in both eyes. Both eyes he had a subluxated, for no reason at all. for no reason at all, this is multifocal. They had to explant this lens and put a monofocal lens in this patient. But for no reason, this is one of the cases we're in. Another patient with a hydrophilic, acrylic, refractive multifocal lenses. There is a capsular phimosis. The multifocal became a multifocal inside the eye. It started folding back, and the patient had a hyperopic shift. The reason for the hyperopic shift was because the lens started folding back, the lens optic was pushed back. If it moves forward, there will be a myopic shift. Goes back, there will be a hyperopic shift, and the patient was very unhappy. And as soon as it did the YAG laser, you can see on the right side's picture, the optics started opening up. Then case three, refractive multifocal lenses, glare and halos, okay? 6-5 N5 vision. This is a re-zoomed lens on both eyes. You can see a Rexis, which is as good. This is done in 2005. This is as good as a femto Rexis. Perfectly, everything was normal. This patient was a type C personality, but after the surgery, she became a type A personality. Okay, it's very difficult to predict because once she started developing glare and halos on this, she became a very, 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 very troublesome patient. She took the life out of me. In fact, she sued me. And fortunately for me, after 6 months, she died of myocardial infarction. But that is a different issue. But what I'm trying to say is, this is a refractive lens. This is a patient who had a refractive multifocal lenses, and glare and halos was a major problem with the refractive multifocal lenses. It was a very good lens for intermediate. The range of vision was good, but glare and halos was a major problem. And this we have to know, because there's no, till now, there's no technology. That's the reason why I asked Minu the question. Till now, there's no technology by which, or technique, by which you can find out whether the patient will adapt, the cortical adaptation will take place or not. There's no, the neural adaptation is purely subjective. And sometimes neural adaptation, the patient may not have brains at all for neural adaptation. So that is another thing. So significant glare, and another patient, diffractive multifocal. This patient, it's an acrylic, I don't mind telling the name of the patient, this is a plate haptic lens. The plate haptic lenses increase incidence of PCO. And we had to YAG a number of patients. One of the patients developed, many of the patients developed CME. Some of the patients developed CME, and very difficult. And CME in a monofocal patient, to a certain extent, you can manage. But multifocal lenses, they will eat your head. They will eat your head. These patients, because, number one, they paid you double the amount of money or triple the amount of money. That is the entirely reason. And their expectations are very high. When they go in for multifocal, they said they think that they will see like a 20-year-old person. So that is actually not, that's the reason why the chat time is very important. I do the counseling personally in all these multifocal patients. Even today, diffractive multifocal lenses, which was done long time back, thickness, when they came with the silicon platform. This patient developed PCO and went to another ophthalmologist when I was out of the country. And this ophthalmologist didn't even know it was a silicon lens and yagged. Okay, what will happen? Because in thickness lenses, the diffractive surface is on the posterior surface of the lens. In anterior, that is in restore lenses, it is on the anterior surface of the lens. Many of the lenses, it is the anterior lens. In thickness lenses and acry, LISA, it is on the posterior surface of the lens. You yagged it and produced pitting on the lens, and patient developed polyopia, and the patient became very unhappy. Then IOL crack was not uncommon in patients who had multifocal lenses, especially the silicon type, when they came into the market, because there was an incompatibility between the cartridge and the lens as well, and we had to explant these lenses. Again, another patient you can see here, this is a major problem, okay? This is a restore lens patient we implanted long time back, and the patient had 6-5 N5 vision. The reason why the patient was not happy, everything is appearing misty, everything is appearing misty. 6-5 N5. I am able to give, and the patient, no, everything is appearing misty. What is the reason? Can anybody tell me? It is because of the glistenings. It is because of the glistenings. Please understand one thing. Multifocal lenses, there is already a decrease in the contrast because the light rays don't come to a single point in focus in the retina. So there is a decrease in the contrast. On top of that, you add glistenings. On top of it, the PCO. On top of it, CME. All these problems can add fuel to the flame, and the patient will literally cut your head and bury you. Okay? So that will have to happen. Okay, another patient, you can see a case 8, crystal lens. I was the largest number of crystal lens users. Even now I'm using occasionally because it's a good lens for seeing. These patients don't have halos, no glare, but the contrast is fantastic. But Only problem is the near vision, the long-term vision is not very good, especially the near vision. Distant vision is good. But sometimes the crystal lens can move forward and produce what is called a torque of the lens. That is called the Z syndrome. And this lens moved forward and the patient became unhappy because there was a myopic shift. Okay, this patient is a gynecologist. She had a Symfony lens and after the first eye, and she was very happy, 6-5, N5, excellent. First time she said, I'm able to see the difference, make the difference between ureter and uterus. I'm a gynecologist. Because normally, when they take the uterus, they'll take the ureter also, the gynecologist. The first time she told me, sir, doctor, I'm able to see everything very well. But this is the problem I'm having. Okay, what is the problem? Negative dysphotopsia. This problem. Okay, do you have the other eye done? It'll become all right, madam. Okay, the other eye done, she's now titillating two rings. What do I do? Tell me what do I do, Arup. I asked her to wait. No, yeah. I asked her to wait. I asked her to wait for 4 months, 6 months, and then 9 months she waited. After 9 months, I was praying to God something should happen to her. Nothing happened to her. But I'm telling you, something happened to her husband. Her husband developed some serious cancer and she got involved in that. So if they have negative dysphotopsia, you pray to God that some problem should occur to the patient, some other problem. So the negative dysphotopsia will disappear. That will be very difficult to treat this problem. This can happen in monofocal lenses also. But I saw a paper wherein the left eye you keep it vertically, the right eye you keep it horizontally. I saw a paper, that's what I'm doing and till now thing. This patient also had fairly good this thing, but glare also disappeared after some time. Again, case number 10, 60, don't make these mistakes what I have done. Okay, I've done so many mistakes with multifocal, I've burnt my fingers with multifocal lens. I'm going to show you the other side, the rosy side of the story also. 62 years old male, female, both eyes multifocal, beautifully done surgery, 24 diopters, 24.5 diopter. I did the patient unhappy. What is the reason? You see the residual refractive error, plus 2 and 2.25. If you make them myopic, they'll just cut your head. If you make them hyperopic, they will cut your entire family. You make them hyperopic. Am I right? You make them hyperopic because it's gone for them. Both neither distance nor intermediate or near. Everything is gone, screwed up in this. What is the reason for this? I did a, this is the reason. I did a IOL master, lens star, immersion A scan. I do for all these patients. I do an eye trace. Everything has been done for this patient. And it was bang on the target, 24.5. I discussed with Warren Hill. I discussed with Samuel Maskett as well. See the dense asteroid ahalosis in both eyes. The macula was normal. Dense asteroid ahalosis. If the dense asteroid ahalosis, don't implant multifocal lenses. That is because this asteroid ahalosis in some way alters the refractive index of the lens. Okay, this I learned. Even Maskett was not able to, probably. Then I repeatedly asked him, I sent some mails to him. He was able to tell me, probably he alters. That's what is it. It's only hypothetical. But this has happened. So see, yeah. Absolutely. Even though the retina was normal, dense asteroid ahalosis, don't do it. Anything in the posterior segment, don't touch with multifocal lenses. Am I right or not? Minu and Sai. So again, IOL power, I did everything was normal. Music maestro, Ilayaraja. Have you heard of him? Yeah, I did multifocal lenses in year 2006, bilateral, restore, plus 4. He was quite happy for some time. But now, for past few years, he's telling, I'm not able to see the keyboard. I'm not able to see the keyboard as well as I used to see. That is restore plus 4. The restore plus 4, what is the problem is, at that time, restore plus 4 was only was available. Distance and reading at 33 or 35 centimeters. Intermediate is not there. So this man is a music master, music director. You must have heard of him. And he had this problem. You know Kapil Dev, no? All of you know Kapil Dev. He had a restore plus 4 in both eyes long time back in Delhi. Okay? Recently, I was playing golf with him. And he was not able to putt at all. The putting is here. Putting is intermediate distance. I'm so unhappy with this. Because the restore plus 4, so you need to do a maths and find out what is exactly required for these patients. Because at that time, when he got operated about 10, 12 years back, it was only restore plus 4 which was available. Which one? Rhizome would have been done. But the problem with rhizome is the photic phenomenon. The photic phenomenon was there. So glaran, so we need to get diffract the newer lenses, the photic phenomenon is less, but the problem is the other problems. So that's why it's a, the double-edged sword. It's a double-edged sword. We need to make sure the thing. Now, happy patients. Let us see the happy patients. This Dr. Gangadhar's mother, our Dr. Gangadhar Sundar, no? From Singapore. Gangadhar's mother, both eyes symphony. She is an active person, very active. From morning 6 o'clock to 7 o'clock, she is on the wheel, driving. She is a social activist. She drives everything. Again, another patient, she is a veterinary surgeon, very happy with the multifocal lens. This is an ophthalmologist from Russia. He had a symphony lens with me, and he became very happy. Another is a lawyer by occupation. He was very happy with the symphony, an excellent depth of vision lens. And this is my PhD guide, optometrist from Australia. You all very happy with the lenses, which is thing. And I think he had a, the PhD guide had a trifocal lens. This man had a symphony lens, again a trifocal lens. All these people had very important. This again a general surgeon, my cousin in the US, okay? And he also wanted a good range of vision. I put a bilateral symphony lens. He is quite happy with this vision. He is able to drive as well. This is a big business guy from Port Blair, from Andaman. And he also wanted a good range of vision. Occasionally, they don't mind. What is the problem with the symphony? The problem with the symphony is less. If you give them one good thing, the other good thing goes off. The problem with the symphony is, how many of you are using symphony lenses? Okay. The near vision is the problem. Okay. Near vision, they have to keep it here. If they keep it here, tell them not to keep it here. Okay? And always tell your optometrist, tell your all the people to check the binocular vision for these patients. Because I make the one eye a little myopic in symphony, binocular vision. And tell the patient also, don't close one eye and see. God has given you two eyes. No. Don't close one eye and see. If you close one eye, then he'll come and ask you for the refund of money. Okay? Don't close one eye. These are all practical things I'm telling you. Ask them to tell your, right from the security person, multifocal lenses, symphony lenses, binocular vision for distance, intermediate. Don't close one eye. If you close one eye, you are gone. That's all. Okay? This is another patient, the member of parliament for Rajya Sabha. This man, everybody must be knowing. He sings in all the languages. Okay? He has done more than 60,000 songs. A Guinness Book of World Record. S.P. Balasubramanian, he had bilateral symphony lenses. Very happy with him. Okay? And did a concert for me free of cost. Okay, Rajinikanth. Okay? Right? Cataract, Rajinikanth will not be affected by cataract. Cataract will be affected by Rajinikanth. The other way around. Okay, Rajinikanth, he doesn't have cataract, as I said. He's got only nucleus grade 1. His vision is 6-6. I'm only taking care of him. I'm just telling you. But I have told him, future, if he wants, he'll go for a symphony lens. That's what he wants. Now, let's, you have any questions, then I'll go to the, quickly go through the, we have another 5 minutes, I'll finish off, Sai Kumar. Huh? Right, supraphobe region, there are a lot of multifocals which are available in the market now, in the Indian market, which are as good. Some are even better than what you're saying. The only problem I face with the multifocal lenses in the Indian market is the A constant optimization. The A constant optimization, that if you keep on using some, about 100 lenses, you can optimize yourself. So, but before that, you need to go through that that curve, that learning curve. So the supraphobe is a hydrophobic acrylic. It's a multifocal lens. It's got a 3.5, it's a diffractive. It's similar to the Restore technology. The same as the diffractive in the center, about 3.6 millimeter, I think. And beyond that, it's a refractive. It works like a monofocal lens. So the pupil dilates. It works like a monofocal lens. For distance, the pupil constricts. It works like a very good for the intermediate and near vision. So it's got a 4.2 millimeter central zone. I think Restore has got 3.6, 1.8 millimeter refractive zone. It's very good. It's a hydrophobic. It's a blue blocker. It's got an anterior diffractive design. Many of the lenses, as I told you, they got anterior. Some of the lenses like Technis and Acrylis are posterior. When you act them, be careful because it's on the diffractive surface. Decrease halos, you need to all know all this. Decrease PCO and overall diameter and all these things. So this is a supraphobe. It comes as a preloaded lens. preloaded lens. That is the advantage of this lens. It's a very good lens. Because if we don't, if you allow your sisters and staff to touch the multifocal lenses, they may touch the optic with the McPherson and produce a crack on the or mark on the lens. Okay? Even in a monofocal lens can produce a problem. Multifocal lens more so. You have to be very careful. So the non-touch technique, the preloaded lens, is probably your best way to go as far as multifocal lens is concerned. Now, in-focus lens. How many of you are using in-focus lenses here? It is an extended range of vision lens, again made by Appaswamy. I don't have any financial interest. This is really a fantastic lens. Again, the problem is the A-constant optimization of this lens. This has got a central zone here in the in-focus. That is a central zone which is about 1.4 millimeter diameter, which has got an add of about 3.5. So the central zone works for intermediate, works for the near vision, and beyond the central zone, which is up till 6 millimeter, is again, it's also available on the blue blocker. It's a hydrophobic acrylic platform, wherein beyond that, it works for the intermediate and the distant vision. So the in-focus lens, the advantage of the in-focus, so this is the central 1.4 millimeter, 3.5 add, the refractive aspirates for the zone, for the beyond that, it's for the intermediate and the distant vision. It works very well. The range of vision is good. The near vision is not all that good. The intermediate vision is better than the regular lenses. But I'm just telling you, more importantly, the patients, the photic phenomenon is almost nil in this because it doesn't have rings. As long as you have rings on the lens, the photic phenomenon are likely to occur. Please take this concept. Whether it's 22 rings, as in the Technis multifocal, or 9 rings, as in Symphony lens. It doesn't matter. As long as the rings is there. Well, in Symphony, the rings, the photic phenomenon is much less when compared to. But the patient, there are some patients of mine of Symphony lenses complaining of glare and halos. I have told them to wait and come. So this is again a Symphony, the in-focus lens. You can see the central zone. This is not coming in the preloaded platform as yet, but very soon it will come. So this is a very lens, you can go through a 2.8 millimeter the cartridge, and it centers very well, and this is a very good lens. We have got a fairly good follow-up. Then we have the accretive lens made by the IOCAD. The accretive is a multifocal diffractive. Again, the diffractive surface is on the anterior surface, and then it's got an add for about 3.25, and then you have the tri-diff, which I'm using more commonly now. The tri-diff comes in two different platforms. One is the plate haptic design, which has got this thing is there. It's got a 3.8 add, and 3.5 add and 1.8 add, and that is a trifocal lenses. And it also comes in the regular platform like this. So this is the tri-diff, which is made by the IOCAD. Again, it's a hydrophobic acrylic, and it is pretty good as well. Then you have the Define, which is again made by the Auro Lab, which is again a very good lens, which is again on a hydrophobic acrylic, and it's got a diffractive surface, and it designed for uncompromised distance and near vision. 11 concentric rings, which is very good with a 4 millimeter pupil size. This is the tri-diff lens, which is of the plate haptic design, which the only problem with the plate haptic design, I find that the increased incidence of PCO. Otherwise, these lenses are very good. So you can see the plate haptic design going into the lens, going into the, you can go through a 2.2 or 2.4 millimeter. They got a special injector for that. And then you have the something like a the Rainer type, the same concept of about two ads, that is 1.8 and 3.5 in this trifocal technology. So these are the different things. We just tried to do a comparison and a patient selection, just like the way previous speakers have told. And we did the study, 30 eyes of 15 patients, bilateral implantations. Please understand, bilateral implantations are a must for all the multifocal lenses. Whether it's Symphony or extended depth or multifocal, bilateral implantation is a must. Then only the brain adaptation takes faster. Normally, I do both eyes in about a week. What is the duration you are having, Minu? Sai? So these are the post-operative pictures. I want to go through it. It's the routine stuff.
We have one more
time. Yeah, we close it up. That's all. Yeah. So the halos and glare and everything is less. Biocompatible, good in all types. Resume, Technis, rest, I'm sorry, not seeing the Indian multifocals. Indian multifocals definitely have a good place in the market. Excellent distant near vision, excellent biocompatibility. Least piece, you have good contrast sensitivity, blue blocker. If you're able to optimize the A constant, my patients do drive without glasses, use computer without glasses, and need a cell phone without glasses, many of the patients. So these are the things I wanted to share my personal experience as far as the multifocal lenses are concerned. And thank you very much, Sai Kumar, for the wonderful opportunity.